We are tracking the tropics and we are tracking Invest 98L. I want to show you what it looks like on satellite imagery. This is just blob clouds is what it looks like at this point, but we are waiting for it to carve out some of that lower level circulation. When that happens, our forecasts should get more and more accurate because the models, they struggle less when there is a clear cut area of rotation, circulation, whatever you want to call it, associated with the storm. We still have to wait just a little bit longer for that to happen. Some models are indicating we could see that a little bit later on today, but also it could also take a little bit more into this week by midweek or later than that. So this is what it looks like in terms of the odds, 50% over the next 2 days, 80% over the next week. That was bumped up just before 8 o'clock today. But where is it going to go? I showed you some tracks a couple of minutes ago, but check this out. I know it looks crazy, and that's because it is in one way. These are all the ensemble models for possible tracks for this invest, this wave that we've been monitoring, and it shows an decent spread across the Caribbean, with most favoring that curve off to the north, but then some keep it tracking towards Central America, moving into very, very, very warm Caribbean waters on the western side of the Caribbean Sea. That doesn't always spell good news for tropical systems just because of the fact that they like the warm water and there's untapped potential in the Caribbean because things have been so quiet so far this season, luckily. I mean, we really haven't had much down there. But here we are watching to see what this next wave will do. This is that ocean heat content. So you see that patch of orange. That's where we have higher energy there, and storms would love to move into there. But will we see that curve off to the north? There is a chance for that to happen. I'll show you future casts a little bit later on.